Mark Shaman and Scott Whitman wrote that, as well as writing the songs in Smash. And that was Take It Up a Step from Some Like It Hot, performed by Adriana Hicks as the leading lady, Sugar with the ensemble. And if, like Alison, you are desperate to hear one of your favourite show tunes on the radio, well, just email me now, because it just so happens that I'm planning two episodes of Your Song Choices for the end of this month. So let me know what you'd like to hear and why you'd like to hear it. Elaine@bbc.co.uk, and maybe I'll be able to put your song in the show. All right, well, it's time for the news now, but don't go anywhere, because coming up is a whole hour of movie songs that weren't in the stage show, but were dreamed up for the big screen version. This is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker, and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 2 o'clock. This is Catherine Cracknell. The Conservative Party has rejected a suggestion from its leader in Scotland that people should vote for whichever party has the best chance of beating the SNP. Douglas Ross told the Sunday Telegraph the public knew how to vote tactically. Scottish Labour's deputy leader Jackie Bailey says the party can win seats on its own.
People are telling us that they are sick and tired of both the UK Tory government and the Holyrood SNP government. They want change. They're telling us, and increasingly the polls are telling us, that the change they want is Scottish Labour, and we are working very hard for every single vote that there is.
A union survey of teachers suggests 1 in 8 has been physically assaulted by a pupil in the last year. Almost 8,500 members across the UK took part in the NASUWT study. Many reported they'd been kicked, bitten, punched and slapped. The Department for Education has said no teacher should expect to suffer abuse. The father of two British Israeli women who were shot dead in a suspected Palestinian attack in the West Bank on Friday says he's confident that justice will be done. Rabbi Leo Dee's daughters, Rina and Maya Dee, who were 15 and 20 years old, died when their car was shot at in the Jordan Valley. Rabbi Mordechai Ginsbury from Hendon United Synagogue in London knows Rabbi Dee.
We had a brief conversation, naturally, as are we all, devastated, shocked at how in just a few moments, with an act of absolute evil and madness, insanity, things can change around. The loss of two gorgeous daughters and his wife now lying critically ill in a hospital in Jerusalem.
The National Medical Director of NHS England, Professor Sir Stephen Powis, has warned this week's four-day strike by junior doctors could cause unparalleled levels of disruption. The walkout in England over pay is due to begin on Tuesday, straight after the Easter Bank holiday weekend. The British Medical Association, which represents doctors, says ministers have yet to make a serious offer. Pope Francis has presided over Easter Mass at the Vatican just over a week after he left hospital following treatment for bronchitis. Crowds of Catholic worshippers gathered in St. Peter's Square to hear the pontiff call for the ending of conflicts around the world.
Help the beloved Ukrainian people on their path to peace and shine the light of Easter upon the Russian people. Comfort the wounded and all those who've lost their loved ones in the war, and grant that prisoners may return safely to their families. Open the hearts of the entire international community to strive to end this war and conflicts that are bloodying the world.
Golf and Tiger Woods has withdrawn from the Masters at Augusta just before the delayed third round was about to restart. The five-time champion said he'd aggravated an existing heel injury. He was 6 over par after 7 holes of his third round and was sitting last of the 54 remaining players. And that's the BBC News at 2:03. Now let's get the latest travel news. Here's Orna.
Catherine, thank you. And Falkirk, the M876 was closed northbound from the M9 at Kinnaird House at Junction 7 through to Junction 3 at the Bowtrees Interchange. That was following an accident, so it's still slightly slow there. West Lothian queues are on the M8 on the eastbound side at Livingston at Junction 3. It's only a breakdown partly blocking the road. The A19, that's where the vehicle caught fire in County Durham. It was on the northbound side near the Peter Lee roundabout. And Northumberland, the A69 is closed at Corbridge. That's after an accident, and and it's from the A68 Stiford roundabout. Cumbria queues have been on Rothay Road, the A593 heading towards Ambleside, still slightly slow there, and Lancashire, the Blackpool Road, the A5085 closed in both directions at the junction of Ribbleton Avenue after an accident. Gloucestershire queues on the M4 still there westbound heading towards the M5 at junction 20. That's where the car caught fire. It looks as though that lane closure has just been lifted, but still taking you about half an hour to pass through that section. And Surrey queues on the M25. The clockwise side along the bottom at junction 6 at Godstone queuing there. The anti-clockwise queues across the top 26 to 25, Waltham Abbey to Enfield. A broken down vehicle in one of the lanes. The M3 northbound just ahead of the M25. One of the lanes was closed at junction 2, but it's caused queues back to junction 3 at Lightwater and Euston Station closed to the West Coast mainline.
On the BBC Sounds app. BBC Radio 2.
Come on, Annie. Let's go to the movies.
Let's go see the stars.
Cowboy here.